And welcome back to Let's Play. Let's Play Dun Dun. Pillars of Eternity, The White March, Part 1.
Hey.
He used a lot of his power potions, so let's move a little bit around here. Did I say power potions? Is healing potions, whatever they are. Major endurance potions. Okay.
Of course.
Alright, we're still heading down to this area. We got the workshop. We got the little discs for this door here. We tried to get up here and one of them grabbed Adair. Did I say durance instead of Adair? I don't know what the hell I'm doing tonight. Okay, we've been in there. So down there we want to go. These discs go to a door. Over here. Still sneaking, just with sped up gameplay. Now let's take note of this. I'm going to write this down. This might have something to do with the order here. North. West. South. And obviously, east. This is where they were all trying to get into and couldn't open. Right. So this was a few episodes ago. I'm going to read this again. As you approach the door, you noticed a round depression within the surrounding frame. The molding around the depression is elaborately carved, with a row of foreign symbols lining the topmost edge of the circle. The depression is about 3 finger-widths deep, with a few small stone fragments jutting out from within the wall. Some pieces seem to rotate independently along slots, but they have no obvious effect in and of themselves. Place the stone disc in the socket. At first, the disc does not seem to fit, until it is oriented a specific way. You hear a quiet click of casings as it sinks into place. Nothing appears to happen right away, however. On the disc itself, an arrow-shaped protrusion points north. Alright, so we saw it north, right? I had not played this before. This is blind. This is from my endless, my little, Skyrim puzzles. Tells me to do this. Alright, don't push the disc, because this is a, what do you call it? This is a combination, I believe, and we want to go west next. So if we rotate the dial counterclockwise, right? If this is like a compass, it should be north, that should be west. The dial rotates easily enough, though you hear a peculiar rattling behind the wall. The dial comes to rest with a faint click. The arrow points west. South. Counterclockwise. So you're going to go all counterclockwise. The arrow points south. Now you want to go east. The arrow points east. Now push the disc. The dial spins out of your hand, it makes a complete revolution and rises so that it's flush with the rings once more. It comes to rest with the arrow pointing north. Dun dun! Did we do it? Aha! As you turn away, you hear a faint grinding of stone. The dial faces north once more. Well, it was already facing north. Did that do it? No? Maybe these are out of order. Maybe it's supposed to go... That seems like the end. Maybe it goes this way. Okay. Ah, okay. The sentence has to make sense. A sentence. A cold wind from the south reached Ovalia in the west. Okay, a cold wind from the south reached Ovalia in the west. And bore our parents east to seek the White Forge in the north. I was wrong, guys. The sentence has to make sense, so it's Swen. Southwest, east, north. Okay. South. So we want to go west now, so we're going counterclockwise. No. No, that's clockwise, right? South. West. How do I go? I have to go past another direction to head east. East. And counterclockwise, north. No? What, man? That's... A cold wind from the south. See, that doesn't make sense. And a cold wind from the south reached Ovalia in the west. Cold wind from the south. Yeah. A cold wind from the south reached Ovalia in the west. Seek the way. Unless it's... it doesn't make as much sense. A cold wind from the south reached Ovalia in the west to seek the White Forge in the north dot and bore our parents east. That doesn't make sense. Maybe I have to push it every time? Oh! I have to push it after each one, I bet. So telling it, okay, this is south. There you go. You have to push the disc after each direction. That's what it is. The door is still locked, but this feels like a step in the right direction. Thank you, game. Counterclockwise, or clockwise actually. West, push the disc. You feel another thunk and find that the dial is recessed further still into the stone rings. That's being nice now. East. After another small thud, the dial sinks a hair lower into the stone molding. The change is almost too small to see, but it seems to indicate progress. North. You press the disc as the arrow points north. At first, nothing seems to happen, but after a few seconds have passed, the disc recedes deeper into the socket. You hear a clunk and a rattle of chains, and the door nearby swings open. The way is clear.
Time to see and not be seen.
Sneaky sneak time. Doing this. I'm just saving a lot, guys, because I've had to repeat sections of this mine over and over again due to various things that happened. I can turn off fast mode here. All goes down. Down into the foundry. Okay. Gonna do something a little weird here. I hate leaving stuff undone. I'm gonna go to the top. Hopefully nothing will engage us on the way. If we see something, we'll stop. So far, so good. Okay, I want to go up there. So I have a feeling that'll just be a small area. We have to go all the way through this? Oh, that's right. That's barring the way.
Be cautious.
Be constant. Durance has discovered something. What'd you find, Durance? Danger? I don't know what he found. An upper section of the side of the tower has crumbled, blocking access within. Was that always there? Minor gauntlets of accuracy. +3 accuracy. Now, can anyone use this? Gauntlets of accuracy. Deflection. Deflection. Attack speed. He doesn't seem to miss a lot. Dexterity. Oh, accuracy. +5 accuracy. The other one's +3? Yeah, alright. Not an improvement then. +10% melee damage. What's better, to go for accuracy or swift? Accuracy, damage, or swiftness? I don't even know. What do you guys think? Just by the time you see this episode, I'm probably done with the game. I'm like way ahead at this point. Oh, here's another thingy. I wonder what it says Durance found. Potion of Flame Shield. Pretty cool. And 35 cogwheels. Alright, so this
All right,
is...
then.
This is really nothing. See, I thought it was something small like that.
And what does the flame reveal?
It reveals stairs. Hello? I've reached the bottom level of Durgan's battery. It's strangely hot. It seems the dwarves made their last stand down here. The White Forge is somewhere on this level, too. How big is this level? Oh, pretty big. Several skeletons have been laid alongside one another. Their legs and ribs are broken, but a dented Abaddon statue has been left amongst them. Oh, hello.
Together! We're in this together!
You'll turn into specters at some point and attack us, aren't you? Well, maybe not. They disappeared. The ones who disappeared, you know, might not attack.
I'll organize the troops to guard the stairs. We can hold them off for a while.
Let's maroon.
Vazel's repairing the guardians. Elune's preparing for the...
That's someone with that cool name, Exandru. I like that. Zoltan.
You can't be serious about this. Let's just wait those monsters out. Abaddon wouldn't let us...
Abaddon rewards earnest work, not begging and cowering. We must hurry.
I only saw two run away.
Keeping an eye out.
I don't like the way that throws us at a sneak like that. Let's look at this thing. It's highlighted, but I can't do anything with it. No, let's go this way.
Arm yourselves, soldiers!
Alright. Yeah. Three lockpicks out of 144. Yeah, I think we could spare it.
That's settled.
Yeah, I'm kind of abandoning my, let's just open
no
doors
problem.
As we find them at this point. Okay, exceptional armors. Ram horn helm. And a winged helm. These aren't anything special. Gauntlets of swift action. We have those already. Girdle of the Driving Wave. That's what, what's his name? Kana has one of those. All it does is grant knockdown. I don't know. I think one of us could use that. It's a... It's a belt, right? Took it, yeah. Oh, here it is, duh. Knockdown. That's all it does. Oh, she already has one. Okay. mean, knockdown's pretty good, but a lot of us can knock down stuff right now, so maybe we'll keep our immortal protection and stuff like that. Yeah. Cool, camping supply. Two lockpicks to replace two of the three that we used to open that. Okay. Good enough, good enough. Something pulled this construct apart like a child's toy. Yeah, what were they so afraid of? Whatever it is, I'm sure we're gonna fight it ourselves as well. You close
that
door.
We'll give ourselves for the battery.
Well, you're opening doors. I mean, you're closing doors. I'm opening them. Pargrunen histories lie open and abandoned. Some are missing pages.
The records are here. Keep searching.
Is this safe, Curate Loon?
No, it's necessary.
Hmm. Oh boy, I hear that frickin' thing. I hate those. Ancient scrolls have been yanked out of the shelves and left on the floor. Yeah, I wonder who would have done that. Skull of Maelstrom, restore major endurance, and revival. Excellent. Wait, I want... Oh, I put that in stash. I want to do that. Who has revival? I forgot we had it, too. Could have used it. One of these encounters. Okay, let's grab this other one out of stash. We never use them, but... Oh, wow.
Air shows me something new.
Is that what she was looking for? Oh. Unless they were scrolls they were looking to use to defend themselves. Ray of fire. Two of them. Nice. I love stacking stuff, I tell ya. I know someone has that. No? Concussive missiles? Maybe I was thinking about another missile spell? So. Torn scrolls and books with broken spines litter the floor below the shelves. Boots of speed. And Annals of the Pargrunen. This has got to be new. Let's put it into stash and make sure. If we see it by itself, that means it's new. Annals of the... Yeah, we'll read it. Why not? It was in the time of Edrahil, the sure-footed, that we came to Cleobon Ralag, an ancient place of the Builders, as the locals called him, Ingwithans. It was a marvelous sight, a door in the mountain framed by a pair of ghoulish aspects, though some exercise of trickery, or through some exercise of trickery or cunning, Edrahil was able to gain access for our scholars that we might observe and record what lie inside. We discovered a foundry of sorts, the like of which neither we nor our distant brethren had seen. Through careful observation, we surmised that the ancient had used this place to extract souls and transfer them to suits of armor. Delicate and challenging work, yet the scale they had achieved left us humbled and surrounded. Astounded. I'm really stinking tonight, I don't know what the hell. Perhaps most remarkable were the golems, living suits of armor powered by essence. We lost two of our fellows when the creatures caught us unawares, but once we'd subdued them, they proved quite fascinating. All too aware that our hosts would never again allow us, nor other curious travelers, to visit this place, we took meticulous notes and measurements of all we saw, forsaking bread and sleep until the work was done. No bread! We reported all to Edrahil, whereupon he praised our work and urged us quickly forward, for if such a place lay abandoned in the forest, who can say what other mysteries gods and kith have left in this strange and wild land? So who found all this? I guess this is from the Pargrunen, that they were the ones who wrote it, okay? Okay. It completes this area. I guess we'll look in here. Here's a wraith. Hello, Monsieur Wraith. And... oh, crap.